Have you ever thought about the difference between water flowing in a river and in a pipe? For pipes, geometry, flow rate and roughness are fixed. In this case, we can generally consider the local and distributed energy losses depending on the scale of the analysis. On the other hand, for an open channel flow, many complexities are introduced into the problem due to the variation of the environmental factors. As you can see in the picture, there are a variation in roughness and geometry throughout the river's cross-section. Additionally, with the increase in water depth, the river's wetted perimeter also increases. Consequently, the influence of the vegetation on the roughness will now have to be taken into account. Furthermore, the next picture showed the influence of longitudinal geometry and how it is difficult to describe the problem with the use of a monodimensional model. Sometimes, in nature, there are some logical perturbations, such as change in bed elevation, like a small waterfall, channel width and slope. In addition, there are man-made disturbances, like flood control structure, sluice gates, and other obstructions like bridge supports. So, now what is the key point? We are interested in determining the water depth along an open channel and translate every environmental factor into a mathematical model to draw the water profile. By doing so, we can determine low difference areas at the risk of flooding due to the differential water depths within the channel and try to mitigate this risk throughout variation forms of river training. You can see in the picture an example of a typical water profile both in a steep and mild slope. To solve these problems, you need to know how to compute the critical depth, the normal depth, and the relative position because they govern the shape of the water profile. The presence of perturbation can make determination of the water profileness incessantly difficult because they introduce a non-linearity in the water profile, which we will learn how to approximate. Do you know that there can be rapid changes in water depth? Sometimes this occurs throughout phenomenon called hydraulic jumps, which is associated with a large and rapid energy loss. We will learn how to quantify these energy losses and understand its influence on the water profile. In conclusion, after studying this concept, you will be able to compute water profiles depending on the all variables factor previously mentioned. It is very important to understand all the key concepts because they form the base for the more advanced studies pertaining into the open channel flow. Ultimately, we will use this key concept for understanding flood risk and mitigating this risk throughout variation river training techniques. Additionally, this concept can be utilized for other purposes such as energy generation, agriculture, transportation, and naval navigation. As you have understood, dealing with environmental complexities is difficult and we will learn how to simulate these realities into a modeling domain.